Well, hello and welcome back to Module 5 of this Games-Based Learning in Schools course. Module 5 is all about designing games, and in this short video we're going to have a quick look at some games design tools for younger children. The first tool that we're going to have a little look at is something which is called Scratch. You might remember from the last video we mentioned Scratch Junior. Scratch Junior is available for iOS, Android, and now of course Chromebooks. Scratch has been around for a number of years, but Scratch 2.0 is now completely web-based, and this has been a massive improvement for its use across schools in Europe. If you don't have a good internet connection though, you can still download the previous version of Scratch and use that locally on your machine. Scratch is a little bit like Lego. You basically slot all the different blocks together in order to get your characters to do things. I just wanted to point out a couple of other Scratch projects as well. One of the great things about the Scratch website is you can see what other people have created. It's definitely worth a browse, having a little look through and playing some other people's games. Don't forget that you can also leave feedback. Again, this is a really, really useful thing to do with members of your class. Other things is that there's lots of different videos that have already been created to get you started with Scratch. It's one of the reasons why we haven't created specific videos for this training course. There's lots of really great stuff that's already out there, many of which will already be translated into your own local language. You can find the official Scratch videos on the Scratch website. Finally, I just wanted to flag up World Scratch Day. World Scratch Day is in May every year, and even though it might be too late to participate this year, perhaps it's something that you could put in your diary for next year. You can find out all about World Scratch Day at day.scratch.mit.edu. Coming back to some of the resources that I've already flagged up from the Royal Society of Edinburgh, there are a couple of very, very good resources about using Scratch. One is called Starting from Scratch, hope you understand the joke, and the other one is called Itching for More. Again, it's another joke. Itching for More is an extension of Scratch, which includes another piece of software, which is called Build Your Own Blocks. Again, hopefully these resources will be useful to get you started, but also at the same time provide some progression for your students. The next game creator we're going to flag up is Kodu. Kodu is available from Microsoft. It's available on the Xbox, but it's also available on the PC. One of the nice things about Kodu is that if you're playing it on the PC, you can plug in an Xbox controller, but actually it gives the impression that you're developing games for the Xbox, even though it's just a simulator on your PC. Children really love this. Kodu has got some really, really advanced graphics compared to Scratch, but in doing so, maybe you don't have to think quite as complicatedly about the coding. It's very, very immersive, and you can build things instantly in order to get instant feedback. And let's face it, children and young people demand instant feedback these days. You can also, if you think about it, allow yourself to do some very, very complex tasks. Because you can get your characters to speak and to talk, and you can input text into the game, there's also great potential to develop literacy. A bit like Scratch, it's based on different rules and building blocks, where you ask your different characters to do certain things within a certain context, i.e. when something else happens. Again, it really helps young people develop the concept of computational thinking. Just like any good game engine, you can also change the variables by using things like the physics engine. Again, this provides us a context in order to teach about science. There are lots of different resources out there to support Kodu in the classroom, and some of the best ones can actually be found on the Kodu Game Lab site. There's even an online community where you can discuss and share ideas with other educators. You can find examples of curriculum and also downloadable worlds to either inspire your own ideas or for you to complete from the Resources tab. One other thing, which is new for 2016, is that Kodu is now also compatible with the BBC Microbit. You can use the BBC Microbit to be able to control your characters in Kodu. Another project from Microsoft is something which is called Project Spark. Project Spark is similar to Kodu, but it's more advanced and has richer graphics. It's currently available just for the Xbox One, Windows 8.1, and currently also for Windows 10. There's a number of different game creation tools built within Project Spark, including painting, sculpting, props, and also a way that you can choose your own biomes. Just like Kodu, it's got a physics engine, but the physics engine within Project Spark is also a lot more robust. It takes Kodu to the next level as long as you've got the computers and the infrastructure to be able to support it. Project Spark, like Kodu, also has its own online community. You find it at projectspark.com. And on projectspark.com, there's a whole section of different guides where again you can download different worlds, access an online forum, and also access different curriculum materials. As you probably know, Microsoft now also owns Minecraft. Now Minecraft is a little bit complicated to explain, so I'm going to let somebody explain it who can do it a lot better than me.
Let's go to a place where everything is made of blocks, where the only limit is your imagination. Let's go wherever you want to go. Climb the tallest mountains. Venture down to the darkest caves. Build anything you want. Day or night, rain or shine. Because this is the most significant sandbox you'll ever set foot in. Build a majestic castle. Invent a new machine. Or take a ride on a roller coaster. Play with friends. Build your own little community. Protect yourself with the strongest armor that you can craft. And fight off the dangers of the night. No one can tell you what you can or cannot do. With no rules to follow, this adventure, it's up to you.
So, that's Minecraft for you. If you're still struggling to understand it, what I suggest you do is either have a go yourself or try and get one of the children in your class to show you how it works. It really is quite a fascinating and an immersive world. There are a number of different resources online that can support you in using Minecraft in education. The first one I want to showcase is minecraftedu.com. This was the original Minecraft and education site before Microsoft bought the product. It's still valid and it's still got lots of resources and ideas that you can utilise to use Minecraft in your classroom. The official Minecraft and education site is education.minecraft.net. Again, here is a whole section on resources. These resources include worlds that you can download and also ideas for curricular use. It's important to remember that Minecraft can be used in lots of different ways in your classroom. One of the ways might be having children design and build their own levels, but another way might be just having young people explore structures that already exist, perhaps to learn about some sort of historical or geographical or political context. There's lots of ways that it can be used. A good crowdsourced website is the Minecraft Wiki. This has been produced by the people at Gamerpedia.com. And again, anybody can contribute to this, and there's lots of examples about how Minecraft is being used in schools all over the world. Hopefully you've enjoyed having a look at some of those game design tools. What I want you to do now is go away and have a think about how you might use them in your classroom. I'd also encourage you to maybe go and try and build something. Perhaps using Scratch, perhaps using Kodu, perhaps even building some blocks using Minecraft. Don't forget, as always, there's loads of online support, and if you're using the hashtag GamesCourse, that would be fantastic because it will help bind our conversation and also our computer games that we build together. See you in the next video.